Imagine, if you will, a world without conflict. Peace reigns supreme across all continents. No more fighting, no more killing. Doesn't that sound nice? Food and drink for everyone, a place to live for all. Utopian, sure, but it's nice to think about. But there's one big problem with a world like that. All of the weapons we spent so much time diligently creating would now be rendered useless. They're not multi-purpose tools, they have one purpose, and that purpose is ending lives as quickly as possible. And now they have no aim, no goal, no use. What a sad existence for these weapons. Guns and swords and bladed brass knuckles might be melted down and repurposed, but what do we do with all the explosives? I mean, our nukes could be used for energy generation, but then we end up with nationwide text alerts that make folks think that Pickering's about to become the next Chernobyl. No, instead, we should do the reasonable thing and fire our nukes into the sun, right? Good call. Hello, fellow friends and philosophers, and welcome back to the most mind-bending channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. I'm your voice in the void, Keegan Hughes, and today we're going to be taking a look at a potentially destructive query. What if we nuked the sun? Before we start splitting atoms here, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe for more explosive inquisitions. Outstanding, let's begin. We're all quite familiar with the sun, at least in how we interact with it. We know it as the provider of warmth and weather and light. Without the sun, life on Earth as we know it would not be possible. It is the star at the center of our solar system. A hot sphere of plasma that could fit 109 Earths inside of it, with mass over 330,000 times larger than that of our planet. With mass over 330,000 times greater than that of our planet. How does the sun generate all this energy, though? Well, around 4.6 billion years ago, a gravitational collapse of matter created our universe. Some of the matter flattened out into a disk, which now orbits around the sun. The largest quantity of matter gathered in the center, and became so hot and dense that it initiated nuclear fusion in its core. Yep. That's the sun. Roughly 3/4 of its mass is hydrogen, and the last quarter is helium with a few other elements in small quantities too. It fuses about 600 million tons of hydrogen into helium every second, converting 4 million tons of matter into energy every second. This is the sun's source of light and heat. Someday, way off in the future, the fusion in the core will run out of fuel. It'll diminish to the point where it is no longer in hydrostatic equilibrium, and the core will become much more dense. Eventually, it will transform into a red giant, and could become large enough to swallow up Mercury and Venus while making Earth uninhabitable. Sounds like fun, doesn't it? Don't worry though, that won't happen for billions of years. But would that process be sped up if we nuked the sun? Let's consider that possibility. What is a nuke? Also known as an atom bomb, it's an explosive device that derives destructive force from nuclear reactions. Basically, they use nuclear fission or fusion to release large quantities of energy from small amounts of matter, essentially causing similar hydrogen reactions to those on the sun, but with the express purpose of destruction. One thermonuclear bomb test released energy equal to more than 1.2 million tons of TNT. Would this make a difference in the sun, though? We would have to get a nuke to the sun first in order to find out. The Earth is 150 million kilometers away from the sun, a distance 387 times further than that between Earth and the moon. If we were to fly a commercial jet for around 150 million kilometers, it would take about 19 years. But that is limiting us to our own atmosphere. What if we use the fastest flying spacecraft, the Helios probes? These satellites were able to reach speeds of 253,000 kilometers per hour by using the sun's gravitational pull. If we got our nukes on a vessel like that, it would be able to hypothetically reach the sun in under a month. If everything went right and we were able to make a vessel that could carry a nuke to the sun in under a month, what would happen if we actually detonated a nuclear bomb on the sun? There's a few theories, provided that the bomb doesn't melt before making it. The most popular of these is that nothing would happen. The sun is so immeasurably huge and is constantly outputting energy that dwarfs our entire nuclear arsenal. Even if the nuke got to the sun, it would detonate and the effects would be negligible. We might notice a little blip on the surface, or maybe the explosion would alter the route of some sunspots, causing a solar flare. Otherwise, the sun could continue to work as per usual. Another idea is that nuking the sun would be a good way to signal our existence to other intelligent life in the universe. Patty Alton says that the nuke itself wouldn't have any serious effect on the sun, but if we tossed a bunch of plutonium in with it, other advanced societies might notice. Plutonium is an artificial element and would not occur naturally in the sun, so anyone picking up on this would have to deduce that somebody else put it there. This could lead to all sorts of interplanetary communication in the future. Far out. Nuking the sun leading to galactic diplomacy. We're sci-fi now. If you really want a dramatic answer, I can take it to one final, less than likely conclusion. If somehow the nuclear warhead was able to make it all the way past the corona through the radiative zone and to the sun's core without being destroyed, it might be able to detonate and cause a new chain reaction within the sun. This new reaction could potentially alter the balance within the sun, either speeding up or slowing down its journey towards red gianthood. The likelihood of this happening is infinitesimally small though, don't cross your fingers. In the end, if somehow a nuke made its way to the sun, it would just end up being a grain of sand in the desert, a drop of water in the ocean. Sure, there would be some minuscule immeasurable difference, but the overall function of the sun would not change. It's just a big nuclear reaction being hit with a really small nuclear reaction. Is that the answer you expected? Were you hoping for a more apocalyptic scenario? Would you want to see a nuke fired at the sun? Let me know down in the comments. Speaking of comments, let's have a look at some of your more spicy ones from last time. DarkZord98 says, if The Simpsons doesn't predict World War III, then there's no World War III. I mean, they haven't been wrong yet. I suppose we'll just have to wait and see what our pals from Springfield have to say. Savanch Gupta says, should I study for my exams or not? Yes, always study hard. Knowledge is power. The Snake with a Gun asks, what if snakes had guns? That's a really good question. Honestly, if a snake ever got a hold of a gun, I think we'd probably be screwed. Thank goodness there aren't any snakes with guns though. And Yee says, let's go to space. I'll meet you there. That's all the time we have for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.